Trader Joe's haul.
What's up, pineapples? Welcome back to my channel. So today I have a Trader I was gonna say Trader Hose. Sorry, it's because I called it in real life. Trader Joe's haul, not Trader Hose. And I wanted to show you what I picked up from there because I have never done this type of haul, but I know people do like it. And I personally love watching Trader Joe's hauls. So I figured, hey, why don't I film one myself because I like watching them. So hopefully you guys enjoy this video because I like legit just got back and I was like, you know what? We're gonna film this. Let's do it. I have all my stuff in my bags. Also, I picked up quite a few holiday items since it is the holiday season. There's a lot of seasonal stuff and I'm a big time fan of peppermint. I'm not a pumpkin lover. I'm the peppermint girl. Hi. Peppermint. I definitely want to pick up some peppermint items. There weren't too many. I think I only grabbed one, to be honest, but there's another weakness of mine. Salted caramel. Regardless, I have some holiday items, and then I'm also going to be showing you some stuff that I usually buy anyhow for like quick dinners, quick lunches, and all that. And maybe you guys might want to try it out, and maybe you haven't tried it, and you want to hear a review from someone. So I got you. All right, guys. So now let's get into this Trader Joe's haul. I have my Costa Rica reusable bag that I got when we went. Oh, I absolutely love this bag, but let's get digging into my bags. Okay, so first off, let's start off with an item that we usually have whenever we have the Calbee ribs. We already have some in the freezer, so I didn't pick one up. So whenever we make short ribs, we always have this as a side, and this is the scallion pancake. Now, this is really good because it has like a lot of scallions and also vegetables, and it's just a good side, and if you dip it with sriracha, it's really yummy. You basically just take some oil and fry each side, and it is really good. Now, if you've had this like traditionally in a Korean restaurant or a Korean barbecue, it definitely does not taste traditional, but it's still pretty yummy. I really like it. I picked up one of our favorite rices, and it's a Japanese style fried rice. There's edamame in there, and I don't know, I really like the edamame in the rice. It also has tofu, and it says hijiki seaweed. And then the main thing why I love this is because it's portioned out, so it's not like a ton of rice. So this is perfect for like four servings. And I really love that you don't have to make a whole pot and you just stick it in the pan, you stir it up, and then you serve it with something like orange chicken, which I did buy. Now this orange chicken is super easy. I really like it. I mean, I don't think it tastes like too fatty, so that's another good thing. And it's not overly breaded because I'm pretty picky when it comes to orange chicken. This one is a quick and fast and easy meal. You can always add more vegetables or maybe onions when you cook this. I usually add like extra green onion whenever I make it. The chicken fried rice, just because this is always good just to have. Again, really quick. It's not too much rice. You can portion it out, and I really enjoy this one. So here's a seasonal item, and they have their chicken and cheese tamales. Now I'm excited to try this because I did hear that they are good. Now obviously they will never be as good as the ones that are homemade, made with masa and all the yummy filling and made with love. I don't know how to personally make tamales, but my friend absolutely makes the best tamales with her family. Like, so good. So I told my friend, Lissette, I was like, I can't wait till you guys make tamales. Like, I'm not even gonna lie. I'm so excited when you guys making them. So I was excited to try these just to give them a try. I like how they're just in two. You don't have to buy a whole pack, because one year I did end up buying the tamales maybe like 3 years ago or so, or maybe 2 years. I don't know if you guys have ever bought them, but it came like in a bunch of six. So it's basically like when you opened it up, you had to make them all. So now this one is in the frozen section. The ones that I bought before were just in the refrigerated section. So I don't know. I think they're completely different because the ones that I got, they were like very small and smashed. And these actually look promising because I don't know if you guys can see, but you can already see like the meat and flavoring kind of on the inside. So I got the chicken and cheese. I also got the beef ones right here. I don't know if you guys can see the inside right there, the beef ones. And then the last ones are the cheese and green chili. Now they did have a fourth flavor, but I figured this is already enough, and it was sweet corn with cheese, I believe. So I kind of just wanted to get all savory ones. I know Glenn doesn't really like sweet ones, so I decided to get these. This is probably the one I want to try the most because I love like any like green chili and cheese tamale. It's always my favorite. One thing I want to say is I feel like Trader Joe's is the only place I really buy a lot of frozen items. Whenever I go to like the regular grocery store, I never buy any of like the orange chicken or rices. I don't know. Whenever I make the Trader Joe's stuff, it doesn't taste super fatty or processed. So That's why I have like a lot of packaged stuff. Usually I get everything like fresh, but Trader Joe's is the one place where I just get a lot of like easy meals to make out of the bag. Next up is another item we always buy, and it is the chicken soup dumplings. These are honestly really delicious. I find that these don't taste far off from certain restaurants that we have tried. I know some people are like, what? I mean, I think they taste really good. We love these ones. So they only come in 6, and I think it's a really good side dish just to have. So if you guys have never tried this, there's actually a broth inside the dumpling right here, and I highly suggest just to follow the instructions. Whenever we got this, I would always just put them in our rice maker and we just started steaming them because we have like a separate little top. But if you oversteam them, they end up exploding, which was happening a lot. So just follow the instructions. You just put them in the microwave, because whenever it gives you like alternate directions, I usually do the one that takes longer because it'll end up tasting better. But in this case, just do the microwave ones because they don't pop, they don't explode. And the soup stays inside. Here's a new seasonal item, and I was like, wow, when I grabbed it, I honestly was like, kind of like embarrassed, because I was like, ooh! And it is this right here. I'm like, did they have to make it so long? It's so obvious that I'm getting it. It's already like, my arm is so long, and it's just like coming from the, wait, is my elbow ashy? Oh, I thought it was. Sorry if it is. Ooh! It's like a lightsaber or something. My second weakness is salted caramel, you guys. And I say caramel. I don't know if you guys say caramel. I don't really care. Just as long as it ends up in my mouth, I'm very happy. So this one's called Taste Test of Caramels. And I honestly barely even looked at it because I was like, I saw a question mark, but which is which? It doesn't tell you which one is which. It just says that there's a coconut, Himalayan salted, fig and honey, blood orange, balsamic, and butterscotch. A true test of taste. And it says challenge your taste buds. And I'm like, you know what? I am up for this challenge. I am. This is the kind of challenge I like. But yeah, this is what it looks like. So there's all different caramels in here and you don't know what you're gonna get. It says to cut the caramel into 4s, which I probably will only cut it in halves. Thank God it's only me and Glenn. And then you're supposed to put toothpicks and then you write down your answers. We ain't gonna do all that. We're probably just gonna honestly just cut it in half and see which one we ate and move on to the next. Next up, I got this for the salads. Now, this is crumbled goat cheese. You guys, I'm a big time fan of goat cheese. So whenever I pick up the salads from Trader Joe's, I always take out like the cheese that it comes with. Like if it comes with feta, I literally will sit there and pick it out as much as I can and replace it with goat cheese. Or a salad that I'll show you in a second, it has a ball of blue cheese. I just toss it in the trash and I replace it with this. There's something about goat cheese that I have always loved, and I don't know, I know it is an acquired taste, but I love replacing any cheese in my salads with that. This is new. So since Thanksgiving is coming up, they have a ton of like green beans and cranberries and already made cranberry and sweet potatoes already cut, like a ton of stuff. They had the mashed potatoes. They have it all, you guys, all the macaroni and cheeses and all of that. Now this is something that I thought that was kind of cool to try out, because this we're not gonna eat during Thanksgiving. I figure this can just be a regular side because it's not too big. And it's called one potato, two potato. And it feels like it's in a tray. Yeah, it feels like a paper tray that you probably bake. What's inside is a creamy, cheesy gratin of sweet potatoes, potatoes, and mushrooms. I've never seen this, so I think this is like the first time I've ever seen this. I think it's a completely brand new item, but it looked really good. Ton of different like stuff in the frozen section, like hot dogs in a puffy. Oh no, they usually have those. I don't know. There's, oh, cranberry with brie cheese, and then there's like a puff pastry with just brie. So if you guys need appetizers for Thanksgiving, I would totally just go and just grab a couple boxes of different things. I have the pork shumai pork dumplings. Now, with all the stuff like the soup dumplings that I have, here, I'll show you again. Like the soup dumplings, and then we have the pork shumai, and then I'll make like a little rice or something. We kind of always have like our own little dim sum type of day, and the items actually taste pretty good because sometimes you don't want to go drive to a restaurant or you're craving it. I highly recommend trying them out. They are not bad, you guys. And usually whenever I pick this up, this is one of the items that tends to like sell out sometimes. So when I was there today, there was only like 2 more pork and like a couple chicken. So if you're not a fan of pork, they do have chicken. I don't believe they just have like a veggie one, because Yeah, they just don't. But I know they do have vegetable options, like vegetable wontons. These are so bomb. Like, I love them. I don't have anything to say, but they just taste really good. Then a new item I wanted to try is the chicken cilantro mini wontons. Like I said, we usually have like a little dim sum day, and I wanted to try these out. I've been wanting to try these out for a while, but since we just have like our staples, like the soup dumplings and the pork shumai, we usually get the pork and chicken. I said, hey, let's try the chicken cilantro wontons. So hopefully they're good. Let me know down below if you guys have tried these out. Now I got three of our favorite salads. Now Trader Joe's salads is something where I'm like, I either love them and all of a sudden I completely hate them, but these three are like our top favorite that we usually get all the time. We have the chicken salad. They do have one with like, it's a Thai chicken salad and it comes with peanut dressing, but for some reason I get really tired of that one. This one comes with a sesame dressing, so it's a little bit lighter. I think the peanut butter dressing gets a little bit too heavy and like, I don't know, I don't really care for it. So this one's nice and light. Next up, we have the barbecue chicken salad and then the baby spinach and green salad. So remember when I was telling you about that little blue cheese ball? So that I'll completely grab and toss out and then I'll replace it with the goat cheese crumbles. And I'm telling you, try it out. For this salad especially, something about goat cheese with a cranberry, it's like so freaking bomb. Also, another salad I like to do that too is the Greek salad, which they had no Greek salads tonight, and I was really, well, not surprised. I kind of went like during prime time, like 5:30, so they were completely out, but I usually use these also for the Greek salad. Next up, I got the hummus quartet. This one has spicy hummus, tomato basil, regular hummus, and then roasted garlic. I've never gotten the quartet. I usually get like two tubs of the original and then a garlic, or like the garlic and spicy, but I said, you know what, let me just get one. So we just use one because I find that whenever we open one, we forget about the other. Sometimes with Trader Joe's items, like once you open it, perishable, they kind of go and expire kind of quick. So I ended up just getting this one because once we open one, we'll try out all the others. And then I'm sure you guys are probably tired of it, another goat cheese. Now this goat cheese block is, I don't know how you say it, chèvre with honey. Now it's a sweet goat cheese. This is so bomb on different crackers. I don't use this on my salads though, just because I don't think it's a good combination. I like just the regular, more like pungent, sour goat. Well, it's not sour, but I don't know. Glenn says it's stinky cheese, but this one's sweeter. So this one to me doesn't taste good on the salads, but on crackers, yes. I randomly buy this, and this is the tomato feta soup. I really like this with like a good old-fashioned grilled cheese if you guys haven't tried this. Now, I ended up picking this up because my friend Journey shows this every now and then, and she actually makes it into like a pasta soup. She'll boil this, and then she'll add like different types of pasta, and then she'll add zucchini, like extra onions, carrots, and she makes it into more like, you know, fancy soup instead of just having it plain. But just plain, I'm telling you, it tastes really, really good. But I really like adding like the zucchini and all that like herb because it just brings it up a notch. Soy chorizo, I absolutely love this one because it tastes good and it doesn't give me a stomach ache. I have only two more items, and I have the scallop cracker trio. It has rosemary, red chili, and garlic crackers. I've never tried this before, so hopefully I like it with my goat cheese. And then the last item is finally my peppermint item. I can't believe I only bought one peppermint thing, but it is this, the peppermint pretzel slims. It's a thin, crunchy pretzel with creamy coating and peppermint sprinkles right here. Now, the only reason why I bought this one was because there was another one that it was dark chocolate covered marshmallows that were peppermints, but I'm not like the biggest fan of marshmallows. Like, I'll have like one maybe or two, but to have like a whole box, that's just too much. And I know Glenn doesn't like them either. And then they also have peppermint bark, which I love the Ghirardelli chocolate bar, so I'm just gonna stick to that. And then they had, if you guys don't know, Trader Joe's has their own version of an Oreo called the Trader Jojo's. Now they had peppermint Jojo's. Now I didn't get them because Oreo, the original Oreo brand, has their own peppermint Oreos. So we already have those. We haven't opened them up, but there's no point in me getting like the Trader Joe's brand and all that because that's just way too much. But yeah, this is the only peppermint item I got, which I'm really surprised because I literally went for peppermint stuff. I almost forgot my two little babies that I saw right when I entered. They had this little baby poinsettia, and I think it's so cute, and they have glitter on it, except the glitter does not stay, so FYI. You just have to be really careful. And then look at this little baby Christmas tree, because since Christmas is coming up, I want to decorate my background with more Christmas stuff. And I thought this was so cute. Now, I can't remember how much these were. I believe this one was $1.99 or $2.99, and I couldn't tell you. I think this was $4.99. Nothing like crazy, you know, because Trader Joe's is always reasonable with prices, but I thought these were so cute for my room. I believe poinsettias are poisonous to dogs, so we never get them or put them outside, even though I love them. But I figured this is like the perfect way to, for me to get like my fix, because I can just put it in my room, the dogs don't come in my room, and it's perfect. Also, they have a Trader Joe's advent calendar for cats. Well, first they have it for us humans, but more importantly for cats and dogs. Now, there was a ton of cat ones left, but I cannot find the dog one. So many people have been sending it to me, and I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna get it. But then I went today and they didn't have it. And then Glenn's brother works at Trader Joe's, and I said, hey, can you get us the dog calendar? He's like, we only have the cat one. So I don't know, I need to look for the dog one. And if I don't get it, it's okay, but I really want it. So just an FYI for all you cat and dog lovers out there, they do have advent calendars, and it's just like a little mini treat. I don't really know exactly what it is. I've only seen pictures of the box, but hopefully I get it for all three of my dogs. Like, I think that would be so cute. For Vlogmas, I always have an advent calendar and Glenn, and our dogs always like surround us like, what is it? What is it? So I think it would be so cute if they have their own. So I'm searching for one, but if not, maybe I'll find like a different brand or something. That is it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know down below if there's something I should try out. Maybe I missed something. Maybe I just didn't see it, because I totally got distracted by all the Christmas stuff that I didn't get pita chips for the hummus, and it just hit me right now. But I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Don't forget to subscribe to your girl, show some love down below, and I will see you guys in the next one. Mwah.
Here we go, it's all about you, it's all about me, it's all about what we do. Making art, you and me, trying to find something to believe.